I spent a few days walking around the streets of Hong Kong. I drank coconut milk from a real coconut. I saw the sights of the city. I got the jade amulet from the hotel to look at one evening during dinner. I left the jade amulet on the table when I went to the washroom to wash my hands. When I went back to the table, it was gone. I spent the next day still touring Hong Kong, including the boat ride at Victoria Harbor, but I could not fully enjoy the sightseeing because I thought of the missing amulet. When I got back to the hotel, I went to my room and I saw a note on the door that I was to report to hotel security. I was really worried. Security. This does not sound good. When I got to the security office, the security guard had presented me with my missing jade amulet. The desk clerk had noticed it sitting on the table and wanted to hold on to it to protect it. He left it with the security guard with a note to look for me. I left Hong Kong with a very good feeling. On the flight back to Canada, I saw another article in a magazine dated January 2011 about China's century. In 1911, nationalist leader Sun Yat-sen's nationalist troops had stormed the Forbidden City. They looted the imperial compound and stole many priceless treasures. Amongst the treasures procured was this priceless jade amulet, which was owned by many past kings of China. The amulet offered heavenly protection to the emperor, too, as the Lord of Heaven. When I got back to the old age home where my grandfather was staying at, the nurse told me that he had died. She also said, "He left me a note to pass along to you." I read the note my grandfather had left me. It was in his handwriting and it was written in English. All it said was, "The jade is for you."